गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, आई वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर द वैलिडेटरी फंक्शन ऑफ 1 वीक ऑनलाइन इंडक्शन रिफ्रेशर प्रोग्राम ऑन आईओटी स्पॉन्सर्ड बाय आईएसटी एआईसीटी ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ एजी पाटिल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी सोलापुर. आई वेलकम टुडे चीफ गेस्ट फॉर वैलिडेटरी फंक्शन मिस्टर एम ए काकड़े, प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ शांति एजुकेशन सोसाइटी ऑनरेबल श्री एजी पाटिल, सेक्रेटरी ऑफ शांति एजुकेशन सोसाइटी ऑनरेबल श्री एस ए पाटिल, कैंपस डायरेक्टर डॉक्टर एम ए चौगुले, प्रिंसिपल डॉक्टर एस ए पाटिल, वाइस प्रिंसिपल डॉक्टर वी वी पोद्दार, कोऑर्डिनेटर प्रोफेसर एस वी कुलकर्णी सर, ऑल द रिस्पेक्टेड रिसोर्स पर्सन, एचओडी ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट्स, माई कलीग्स एंड डियर पार्टिसिपेंट्स. In these 6 days, we have learned and understood about the different aspects of IoT by eminent speakers from academia and corporate world. Now, we are at the end of this program. We are delighted to have Mr. M.A. Kakde with us as the Honorable Chief Guest of the Validatory Ceremony. I would like to introduce our today Chief Guest, Mr. Kakde sir. Mr. Kakde is a director of Board of Examination and Evaluation at Savitribai Phule University. He is an executive member of IST New Delhi and a chairman of Indian Society of Technical Education Maharashtra Goa section. He has registered for PhD to Shivaji University Kolhapur in Earthquake Engineering. And he has published 4 national and 2 international papers. He has extensive experience of industry, teaching, and administrative. He has contributed in academics by introducing very new subjects like earthquake engineering, advanced construction material, water management, town and country planning, etc. In administrative work, he has experience of 4 years as Assistant Secretary of MSBT and also worked in different domains like looking after academic and examination activities, controlling 200 plus examination centers, managing assessment, in charge of all inquiry cases related to misconduct, malpractices and other illegal acts happened in exams and many more. He has also done consultancy work for industries like RCC, design scrutiny, soil investigation for footings and like that. His significant contributions made in community development program by working as program coordinator of IST, MSBT and NPEEE approved programs. His remarkable achievements includes notable contribution and involvement in development of online academic monitoring software of institutions. He is a member of task group established for granting academic autonomy to polytechnics in the state of Maharashtra. He has worked as a project officer for scheme of community polytechnic of Government of India. Sir, we are very glad to have you as a chief guest for today's function. Now,
thank you.
I request our Vice Principal, Dr. V.V. Poddar, sir, to say a few words on this program.
Good afternoon, everyone. Hope I am audible and visible.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, good afternoon, one and all. Respected chief guest for today's valedictory function, sir, from Pune University, our campus director, Chaugule sir, principal sir, all HODs, the coordinators for this workshops, those were conducted in 3 phases. Vedula madam, S.V. Kulkarni sir, and Darekar sir, and respected and other participants. At the outset, I would like to welcome you all for this valedictory function. And I'm very much overwhelmed to see wonderful feedbacks from all the participants. I think at AGPIT, we have been striving very hard to conduct such value-added programs for the upliftment of the knowledge for the upliftment of the society in total and enriching the faculty members with knowledge in upcoming areas. And I'm really pleased to share with you that all the three phases, we had tremendous response, and the participation from the participants was pan-India. So people from various states, they joined these workshops, which was conducted in three phases. And I would like to thank IST and AICT also for providing us this opportunity to conduct this workshop, this refresher program on this area of Internet of Things. As we all know, friends, IoT is the buzzword today, particularly in healthcare systems. Every day we are seeing the developments for developments in the IoT applications in healthcare. Our students are also working on this oxygen concentrator project. Students from electronics and telecommunication department and students from mechanical engineering department are working on this area of development of concentrators, wherein this knowledge of IoT will be very much useful. So let me congratulate all the organizing committee members, and let me thank all the participants for their participation. And I hope in future, wherever we get an opportunity to conduct such programs, we'll always be there to provide to disseminate the knowledge in the upcoming and upfront areas. Once again, thank you all. And I hope all the participants who already shared their feedbacks will be eager to listen to our honorable chief guest, Mr. Kakatkar. So thank you once again.
Thank you very much, sir, for your appreciation and motivating words. Now, I request our principal, Dr. S. A. Patil, sir, to say a few words. Over to you, sir.
Good afternoon, all. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good afternoon, all. So, all the dignitaries who are present for this function, and our today's chief guest, Mr. Mahesh Kakde. So he is a friend of me. I know him since he was studying in the Walsingham College of Engineering, Sangli. So this valedictory function, okay, so I hope that all the participants from all over the India, they all enjoyed and learned a lot about this Internet of Things. So last 6 days were hectic for you people. So I am sure that you will transfer this knowledge in your own institute to various students. So I heard that there was a lot of you can say participation or enthusiasm from the participants, but finally we had to select 100 participants as per the rules of the IST, and out of that I think almost 60 of the participants, they are pretty much regular and they are attending it. And so this FDP was a huge success. So this is the third in the series. So we already conducted two such, and this one is the last three sessions. I am very thankful to IST AICT for giving us the opportunities to conduct this program. So for the information of our chief guest and some of the participants who are participating in this program, I would like to inform you about our institute. Our institute, A.G. Patil Institute of Technology, was established under Shanti Education Society Trust by our chairman, A.G. Patil, sir. So our honorable secretary, S.A. Patil, sir, he is looking after all the activities of all the institutes under the Shanti Education Society. We have got four branches, 4 UG branches, mechanical engineering, civil engineering, electronics and telecommunication engineering, and computer engineering, and 1 PG program in mechanical engineering, that's management process engineering. So our institute is accredited, affiliated to Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar Technological University, Lonere, since last 4-5 years. And our institute is NAC accredited with B plus grade. And almost 9 batches have passed out, and almost more than 1500 students are serving the nation in various capacity in various industries. And we have got a very good mix of all our faculties. All our faculties are almost all are university approved. And many of the faculties, almost 10% faculties are PhDs, and another 10% they are pursuing their PhD programs. So this is regarding our institute, and I am very thankful to AICT as well as IST, as Mr. Mahesh Kakade, he is also executive director of this IST. I am thankful to all of them, and also I am thankful to Mr. Mahesh for accepting our invitation and gracing this occasion. And I am sure that all the faculties must have enjoyed it, and so without taking much of your time, okay, I am sure that you are very eager to listen to him, and I just hand over to him. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Thank you, sir. Now it's time to listen to our chief guest. I would like to request Mr. M.A. Kakde, sir, to address us. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. I hope that I am audible to you and visible to you also.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Namaskar. And a very good afternoon to all of you. It's a moment of immense pleasure, and I feel delighted to interact with my very beloved friends who are at the elite position of a very well-known and reputed institution. Of course, I know that some of your administrator might have been joined this particular function. Distinguished administrators, faculty members, participants from various states. At the juncture of valedictory function of AICT-IST sponsored induction refresher program on Internet of Things, which is most popular and relevant in today's scenario, organized by the Department of Computer Engineering of A.G. Patil Institute of Technology, Solapur, to which I am associated with the last so many years. I know that it is a very well-reputed institutions, NAC accredited, and it has got its own standing in the Western Maharashtra. Respected Sri A.G. Patil sir, who is the president of Shanti Education Society, and I am also associated with him. Our beloved friends, two of mine friends are there, Principal Dr. S.A. Patil sir and the campus director, executive director, Dr. Chaugule sir, the coordinator of this particular program, Dr. Kulkarni, the co-coordinator Vedula madam, and the distinguished resource person, faculty members, dear participants, ladies and gentlemen. I deem it to be a great privilege and an absolute honor to be here amongst all you, gathering of all knowledge worthy and who are jealous of knowledge. I recollect truly the meaningful sayings in Guru Upanishad, which is one of the important Upanishad of 18 Upanishad. It says that nahi jnanena sadrusham, nahi jnanena sadrusham vidyamahe pavitrate. It means that the entire world is under the knowledge. It means that the knowledge is nectar, which we call it as Amrut. One must remember that the world is power-based. The power is knowledge-based. The knowledge is classroom-based, and classroom is teacher student based. So one can understand the law of equality, and thereby one can correlate the power is related to the knowledge. And therefore, my dear friends, everything which we experience is ultimately an outcome of a knowledge. So dear friend, this pandemic has brought many transformations and alterations in the ecosystem, and so in the education ecology also. Aaj duniya us mukam par pahunchi hai, aaj duniya us mukam par hai jahan jinda rehna hi kamyabi hai. This is what a situation that we are experiencing all around us. Almost the entire 2020 we have lost, and all the golden glimpses without our students in the class, and we are deprived of actual interaction and campus activities. We witness awfully depression, nervousness prevailed amongst all stakeholders. Consequently, it seems that the life has been a bit sluggish. Being teacher, however, we found opportunity in it and tried to accustomed with this paradigm shift. A new pedagogy, the virtual format of teaching and learning, and then interaction, which we did never envisaged. On this occasion, I remember a pretty old story I want to share with you, which I feel are most appropriate on this occasion. At this stage of home quarantine, and we are thrown away from the society and trapped in such a situation that even we could not move out of our own borders. Anyway, there was a kingdom, and of course, you know that a flourished kingdom has got a lot of activities, and one activity, a debate was going on, and at certain, of course, I will cut short the story because I don't want to take your much of time. So there was a debate going on, and some intellectual person were arguing with the king and his secretaries. One person was arguing so harshly that king was angered on him, and he sentenced 3 months isolated confinement in a dark cell. Jala apan anda cell mhanto barak asse ti. He was only provided twice a day food and water, and the record of such a punishment was 100% death in a month's time. Routinely, days were passed off. After 1 month, king got the news that still that particular prisoner was alive and enjoying food and water. He was shocked and surprised. He asked his Pradhan Mantri, main secretary, principal secretary, to present the prisoner. And when the prisoner stood before him, he asked in surprise, how could you survive against all odds and broke this unbroken record? The person answered very wisely, when I was taken to the cell, I took a pin from a table, and at the time of entering, I decided one plan, and accordingly I prepared my daily routine. What was that? Throwing the pin abruptly in the dark room, and strive for searching it. And how to search it? Because that was a very cold, dark, empty room. So I started finding it by fumbling, grappling, by scrawling. This was the objective of my life in that particular dark barrack, just to maintain myself busy and to continue my life. Of course, apart from food and water, I didn't have anything in with me in their custody. Nobody was there to talk to me. Nobody was there to show me some light. But still, I had two very distinctive objectives in my mind. The first one is, which we call it as the drive, prayers or a prerna. And the second one is the reward or prize, which we call it as a Shreyas or a Bakshisi. And these two objectives very essentially required for me to strive in that particular war, to remain live. And that's why every day I used to throw the pin, I used to find it out. And when I got it, I was joyous. I was enjoying that particular moment. That way I kept myself busy. Dear friends, the situation is not so worsened as far as this myth is concerned, that we cannot find small effective drives so as the prize or rewards. Of course, at the outset, let me congratulate all of you who have engaged and kept busy in these small drives of knowledge gain, online interactions, talking to the people, sharing our knowledge. And as a reward, today you are benefited, disseminated with lot of technological terms, ideas, concepts, analysis, results, and whatnot, because we all were engaged in those drives and therefore we are getting it. However, this is not enough, dear friends. Being the frontline educational mentor, I expect handsome contribution from all of you in academic, curricular, co-curricular, research, innovations, from the point of view of our students, colleagues, institutions, and ultimately the society. Of course, somebody was talking just now that oxygen concentrated. Listen.
I think sir has left accidentally. Just wait for a few minutes. He will rejoin.
I had a call from Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir. Am I audible?
Okay. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So there was some urgency and emergency. That's why I had to. Extremely sorry. So, dear friends, I was talking about this particular situation, and being a frontline educational mentor, we expect our contributions in academic, curricular, co-curricular activities, which of course I know that you are contributing to the greater extent for benefit of our students and other stakeholders. Of course, in this situation, all we know that we have to take care of ourselves, our family members. That is of supreme importance. But still, in this situation also, we can contribute a lot. I must apprise our friends A.G. Patil sir and our friends S.A. Patil sir and Chaugule sir and their colleagues that they have undertook this initiative. I must also express my sincere thanks to Dr. Anil Sahasrabuddhi, Chairman AICT, Pratap Singh Desai, Professor Vaidya, because they have taken some drives. And the reward of that is we are at this particular function. We are enjoying this valuable function, and we are happy that we have been disseminated with a lot of knowledge. But so therefore, I personally feel that, and what I expect that, we have to find our own way, and we have to do it. Remember that everybody has a must have the drive, and so as to have the reward. So by doing this particular, one basic objective we have to keep in mind that, main kisi se behtar karu, मैं किसी से बेहतर करूं क्या फर्क पड़ता है, लेकिन मैं किसी का बेहतर करूं बहुत कुछ फर्क पड़ता है साहब। हार्टफुली आई ऑल्सो कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट डॉक्टर एस ए पाटिल प्रिंसिपल, डॉक्टर एग्जीक्यूटिव डायरेक्टर एम ए चौगुले सर, कुलकर्णी सर एंड वेदुला मैडम, दैट योर एंटायर टीम हैज टेकन लॉट ऑफ पेंस। आई हर्ड सम फीडबैक्स फ्रॉम द पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड विद दैट आई रियली सैल्यूट टू यू दैट, बिकॉज दिस इज अ टीम वर्क एंड आई नो दैट यू हैव अ वेरी awesome and beautiful campus and infrastructural facilities. So definitely whatever you take in hand, you definitely give justice to it. Anyway, this particular program is a required one, an apt one, and most beneficial to all teachers, researchers, and of course some administrators also. On this occasion, I recollect Professor Eshpal's quote. You know better who was the Professor Eshpal. He was the chairman of UGS and he served the nation at various capacities, and he was everything and whatnot. So he has wrote a drawback of a education system. Those who make curriculum may do not write the books. Those who make curriculum, they do not write books. Those who write books, they do not teach. Those who teach, they do not set question papers. And those who set question papers, they never go for evaluation. So this is what the mockery of system. Whatever we gain, whatever we have been disseminated, whatever we have gathered, we have to use it aptly and appropriately for the benefit of all stakeholders and ultimately the society. So dear friends, let us do it something differently. And for that, we have to find our own way. Now, when the situation has come, we have started inventing ventilators. We have started about oxygen concentrators. Why not we have thought of this situation earlier? Why not? Because this is internet kind of things. There is a good network of this electronic revolution and the physical activities. Today, when I read, I learned that nowadays a new concept is coming out, that is physics and digital, DigiFac, and people are thinking something different. So all the physical activities we can control digital in a digital manner, to which we call it as IoT, that has spread and occupied the entire world. So therefore, dear friends, we have to find our own ways and we have to envisage whatever is going to be the situation in coming years, and accordingly we have to prepare ourselves. ढूंढोगे अगर तो ही रास्ते मिलेंगे. मंजिलों की फितरत है वो खुद चलकर नहीं आती. कुठलाही मार्ग आपल्याला आपणून मिळत नसतो, तो आपल्याला शोधावा लागतो. सो डियर फ्रेंड्स, दिस पर्टिक्युलर प्रोग्राम, you have entered in the completion of third phase of this program. I must thank AICT and IST because they did fantastically well, that you have been engaged with phases of induction and refresher program. With that, you can think about the ideas converted into the innovation to which I am coming to it. So dear friends, we have to find the opportunities in such a difficult situation, tough situations. Today, we all know that this particular era is marked by cutting-edge technology. And this era is also marked by the infinite information. I know that this particular program may house the young faculty members. Dear young faculty members, today you all are lucky, because whatever we didn't enjoy, myself, S.A. Kulkarni sir, M.A. Chowgule sir, you are enjoying it. You are citizens of the digital world. You are born in the knowledge era, which is fostered by gadgets like laptops, tablets, smartphones, smartwatches, and whatnot, social media like Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn. But still, we must remember that the fact this particular fast-changing world is derived by Trinity. Three buzzwords, like somebody said that IoT has become the buzzword. But what I feel that the basic three buzzwords that we have to understand and appreciate: change, challenge, and opportunity. The real world out there demands to cope up with this trinity. And with what nature? By highest order of, this must be complemented by the highest order of skill, competencies, and ultimately the performance. Dear friends, I want you all to remember that performance leads to recognition. Recognition leads to respect, and respect leads to power. And ultimately, power is related to the knowledge. Therefore, my dear friends, there is only one way to make you and the nation proud, that through execution of performance. This can be only achieved by making an excellence as a habit in our day-to-day life. Dear friends, the life is not about finding yourself. The life is about creating yourself. Tu chahes tujha jivanacha shilpkar. You are the sculptor of your own life. So therefore, dear friends, that the life is not about finding yourself. The life is about creating yourself. There are no limits to what you can accomplish. The limitation only exists in minds. Therefore, another important aspect everybody needs to keep in mind is that your life is a result of choices you make. So this is a new definition of new era, and you have to remember it. It is the digital, internet, WW based world. Therefore, you should be the first one to adopt the technology. And if not, you should not never be the last one. I hope that this particular program has been fully equipped and accomplished with all these technological aspects and features, that you are not going to be the last one. So to take up the constantly changing roles, it is important to focus on lifelong learning. For reskilling and upskilling, and that too on continuous basis, to remain vibrant in this practical world. If you remain idle with this particular knowledge, you will be thrown away. So therefore, my dear friends, never stop learning. Life never stop teaching. This is an innovative and disruptive world. So what I expect from you: be a disruptor using the latest technology and innovation. Bechain asla pahije apan satatyana navin kay karnyacha dhyas ghetla pahije. So you should be the disruptor, and this disruption is so accomplished with the latest knowledge which you can gain through such a programs. And that's why I every time salute to all those policy makers. In this context, dear friends, I remember and I recall a statement of Azim Premji. You better know that. I remembered it because this is from computer field, so you know better that who is an Azim Premji. Of course, you know that he is the founder of Wipro, which is a native international company which has made its own stance in the international forum. Who says that if people are not laughing at your goals, your goals are too small. So what the gravity, the message, the comprehensiveness, the impact of it, you can understand better. So what he suggests, that very recently he has donated almost 43,000 crores of his wealth for the betterment of society. Only such a persons can do, because they think differently. They are the basically leaders. And what he says, that you must have very different types of goals and objectives. And if people are not laughing at your goals, then you are short of it. So this can be accomplished by performing better. So better your performance. This precisely means challenge yourself to think about your own disruptions. Get comfortable with discomfort. To remain certain in a more uncertain world, what we have we have the only one key, better the performance. And performance, better performance comes from the best practice benchmarking. You understand what I'm trying to communicate with you, dear friends? Best practicing benchmarking is a very simple word to hear, but it is very difficult to follow because it requires hard work. It requires dedication. It requires seriousness. It requires an objective. It requires a goal, and it requires the drive, basically. And ultimately, after that, only we can be definitely expecting a reward. So what I expect from you, that you have to start best practicing benchmarking today. And this step definitely take you and start inculcating the qualities of leaders. See, unless you have your own leader, you can't do anything. I don't talk about the other leaders, the leaders in the politics, the leaders in the society. I'm not interested. I'm interested about our own leader. And in this particular context, I remember a very fantastic definition given by our great legendary Swami Vivekananda. He says that leader is the one who thinks unthinkable. Leader is the one who thinks unthinkable, who achieves unachievable, and who sees invisible. So therefore, my dear friends, the key feature of a leader, I am talking about individual leader, is dare to be different. Unless you start doing differently, you won't get the rewards. Unless you start thinking about differently, different drives, you don't get those rewards. So a sign of good leader is not how many followers you have, but how many leaders you create. In this regards or in this context, I thanks Shri A.G. Patil, sir, because, sir, you have created the leaders. Principal S.A. Patil is there. Principal Dr. M.A. Chaugul is there. Vedula Madam Kulkarni, sir, both, all of them are the leaders because they have taken the initiatives under the leadership of Dr. Sahasra Buddhe and my dear friend Pratap Desai. So you become a leader by creating the best practices. And best practices are the outcome of novelty and innovation. How come or how can we do the best practices? This is only possible when you have novelties of ideas, and those ideas must initiate and must force you to go for innovation. Whatever you do, just ask, how can you make it best? How can you make it cheaper? How can you make it most effective? There are so many number of people. There are hundreds of countries who are making the vaccine. But the vaccine which has got more popularity is Pfizer. Only one dose is enough. One shot is enough. We have to take two doses. So this effectiveness plays a vital role for the success. And this is not possible because of novelty and innovation, my dear friends. And this is ultimately an outcome of best practicing and best benchmarking. So faster and better, you have to make it. I feel that in this context, you can understand the time and all those the appropriate actions that we expect. So, dear friends, I feel that innovation must become the part of DNA. This is a very vital ideas given by the policymakers and the philosophers and anthropologists. What they say is that the innovation must become the part of our DNA. I am doing, of course, I started my career as a lecturer in civil engineering at Polytechnic. And now I have been handling such a huge and vast quantity of students, teachers, and institutions of a world-known university, which is known as the Oxford of the East. Only university in the country which has got the reputation of known by the world. So, dear friends, it is not possible because every time, whenever I contributed it with some drive. I contributed with some innovations. This is not the platform to apprise myself, but this is just few success stories that I am sharing with you. And being an administrator or a teacher or an innovator, we are the only university in the country who are running online examination very successfully. during this pandemic also. Today also my examinations are going on. Almost 36 lakh instances we are going to handle. 6.5 lakh students are there. 950 plus odd institutions are there. 30,000 plus teachers are there. So we are handling vast 5,400 subjects, 284 programs, and 6 lakh students. Every day we are conducting the examination in 3 sessions. So this has come because I have got the decision maker powers. And how this power comes to me? Because of knowledge, because of experience, because of novelty of ideas, because of innovations, because of contributions, because of experiences. And those experiences sharing from the friends like Patil sir, like Chogle sir, like Vaidya sir. And we are, all the time, we are in a thought-making process. So therefore, those thought comes to us, and they have really helped us to go and indulge ourselves in doing some things innovatively. So this shall be a DNA of our each and every individual. But I'm not happy with this. Unless it is a DNA of the organization cannot flourish. Somebody was saying that we have that and we did this. Sir, it is a very humble request to you. We have to inculcate this kind of culture amongst all our faculty members, amongst our students, our supporting staff, our management, because of whom only we can have the fruits of success and we can test it. I remember my dear friends, and that's why I said that this shall be the DNA of everyone in the organization, from bottom to top. In this context, I remember the very beautiful thought given by Father of Nation, Mahatma Gandhi. He says that future depends upon what we do in present. Dear friends, it has got a lot of meaning. I don't want to elaborate because I don't want to take much of your time. But still, I feel that what the message he has given, you can understand. The future depends upon what we do in present. And to that, what I feel that and what I envisage and what I understood is that yesterday of tomorrow is today. So whatever we want to do, let us not talk about tomorrow. Or let us not blame yesterday. What we are supposed to do, we are supposed to do today only. I understand a lot of verticals where we can work. But I remember 5 sutras. In today's words, in this particular situation, in new education colonies, we call it as laterals and verticals. So all these are verticals, which I call personally as a Panch Sutras. This is required essentially to uphold and upgrade ourselves, to upgrade our students and our colleagues, society. What are they? Oh, I feel that the first one is a very important one, student-centered education. We all have witnessed that up till now, we had a teacher-centered education, where we used to make curriculum, where we used to make the policies, where we used to make examination and teaching schemes. And those were compelled to our students, they didn't have any freedom. But this has to be changed. The new education policy has a booster dose for this particular idea. And that's why in recent years, my dear friends, you must have heard that we have entered into an era called as a credit system and choice-based credit system. But let me recall you that I'm very much benefited and I am very thankful to all my seniors. In the year 1991, when I was at the Government Polytechnic Kolhapur, we endeavored this idea in the year 1991. We became the very first institution, autonomous institution in the country, which indulged itself of this kind of work. Credit system, choice-based credit system, multi-point entry and credit system, which is now being practiced today. So almost for 30 plus years, we started doing that particular business, and that gave us the confidence because at that time we have a different drive. We started finding out a pin in the dark atmosphere, which definitely give us this kind of impetus. So dear friends, the first very important sutra is student-centered education. The second one is woman-centered family. You can understand better the importance of this idea. Unless the family is governed by our women, we will not flourish. Here, fortunately, you have so many women friends and colleagues who are looking after this particular program. Dr. Udala Madam is here, and I salute to you because you did it fantastically well. I heard some feedbacks. Anyway, third important sutra or vertical is human-centered development. Wherever we do, whatever we do, maybe at the university, maybe the institutions, maybe at research institutions, maybe at state level, central level, everywhere, unless we have a sole objective that whatever development we find, we envisage, we think in future should be the human-centered. The fourth one is very important, the knowledge-centered society. We have the task that everybody should think about this only. Whatever we want to create and whatever we want to give back to our society, that must be making them knowledge-worthy. And fifth one, last one is the research-centered India. Dear friends, we must thank our educationists, we thank our policymakers, because we have invented our own vaccinations. This is a country of 130 billion people. They have 130 intellect and brains. They can do wonders. And being teacher, you can also do the wonders. So I expect that whatever may be your area, you have to contribute, because this will lead to us to be a self-sustained one. And this can be only possible with the two words which I have uttered, research and innovation, dear friends. There are so many areas we can apply this concepts of IoTs, energy, water, food, affordable healthcare, environment, carbon footprints, infrastructure, sustainable development, and whatnot. There are so many areas. You have to find out your own ways of finding out those kinds of areas and those verticals, dear friends. But I must appreciate and I must remember and I must pass on this message to you, that behind every innovation hub or whatnot, what we can call it as, there is a great institution or university. So we are proud that we are at Pune University, Savitribai Phule Pune University. We have so many ideas converted into the innovations and then applicable to the society. We made the ventilators. We are now establishing an oxygen plant in the campus. Why and whatnot? Of course, I'm not going to describe those things in details. But dear friends, what I want to communicate to you, or what I want to pass to you, is that intezar karne walon ko utna hi milta hai. इंतजार करने वालों को उतना ही मिलता है जितना कोशिश करने वाले छोड़ जाते हैं. सो व्हाई नॉट फर्स्ट? दैट्स व्हाई इन द बिगिनिंग आई सेड दैट वी शुड बी द फर्स्ट. सो कीप योरसेल्फ बिजी इन डूइंग द थिंग्स. फाइंड स्मॉल ड्राइव्स, बट दोज ड्राइव्स शुड बी मोस्ट इफेक्टिव, व्हिच मस्ट लीड्स टू द रिवॉर्ड्स, अल्टीमेटली इट लीड्स. बट व्हेन वी आर डूइंग दिस पर्टिकुलर बिजनेस, बीइंग टीचर, बीइंग मेंटर, we are not a dictators nowadays. We shall be the directors. We shall be the guide. We shall be the mentors. And who are the leaders in the eyes of our students. So therefore, when we talk about the leader, how should we lead? We should lead with the character. In order to have a great one cannot compromise the uncompromisable. Never give up. Never give up. With our own ethos and values, and of course the professional ethics in your journey of life. Being teacher, our role shall be the director, the mentor, as I said. And I remember a very beautiful quote in the Bhagavad Gita, which is the extract of Bhagavad Gita. You know that it is, of course, I don't want to connect it with any religion, but being a teacher, being a person striving for a knowledge, he must read everything, whatever is available to us at every time. So in Bhagavad Gita, what it says, that it has mentioned about the role of a teacher. Yatra yoge shvaro krishno, yatra yoge shvaro krishno, yatra partho dhanurdharaha, tatra shri vijayarbhuti. The entire world is in a very difficult and panic situation. We all are puzzled. And everywhere we find that there must be somebody who will take to us to the path of light from the darkness. Yoga Kshema Vaham Viham, what we call it as in Bhagavad Gita. So we have to be taken to the lighter way by our guide, our directors. So being a teacher, you must be a Krishna who is always there in the society, who can take the Arjuna who is in a panic condition, who is a puzzled, who is mumbled and fumbled, and who do not know what to do. So therefore, dear friends, our role is to be like this. And this is possible. This is possible when we have a 360-degree positive approach towards entire thing, towards this life. I remember also here a very beautiful quote and a very beautiful and divine thought given in the Rigveda. What it says that, Anobhadra, Krateshe Yantu Vishwataha. There are millions and billions of good thoughts available in the galaxy, and they all are sprawling upon us. It is up to us what to get and what to do to go ahead. So, dear friends, finally, I think that I have spoke much more because I have got the opportunity to interact with a very intellectual community. The Pradnyavant and Jnanavant Saraswat Mandali Janna Apan Manto Tyanchyashi Bolnyacha Aplyala Yog Ala Aso Tar Khup Bollo Mala Mahit Aahe. Finally, I wish you all the best. Keep sound health of yours and all loved ones. And good luck to all of you for your future endeavors. With this word, and I'm extremely thankful to GLCT, especially for allowing me to interact with and the administrators of this reputed institution. Thank you very much.
Thank you for your valuable words, sir.
Thank you, sir, for your thoughtful and encouraging speech. Each and every word you said was full of motivation. And as you said, we will definitely practice to set benchmarks. Once again, thank you, sir, for enlightening us.
Thank you.
The end of a story is the new beginning for many others. On this note, to conclude a remarkable, memorable, and knowledgeable event, I request Dr. Vedula Madam to deliver vote of thanks. Over to you, Madam.
Thank you, Madam. Very good afternoon to all dignitaries and participants. On behalf of A.G. Patil Institute of Technology, I am privileged to express my sincere thanks to our chief guest, Honorable Sri M.A. Kakade Sir, for giving his valuable time and extremely enlightening words. I am sure everyone has been truly inspired. Thank you very much, sir. I would also like to thank all our resource persons for sharing their invaluable guidance and expertise with all of us. I thank our management and secretary of A.G. Patil Institute of Technology, Sri S.A. Patil sir, for their encouragement and support. I extend my gratitude to our campus director, Dr. M.A. Chevbule sir, for constant guidance and encouragement. I express my sincere thanks to our principal, Dr. S.A. Patil sir, for continuous guidance and encouragement from beginning to ending of all these three programs. I would like to thank our Vice Principal, Sir Dr. B.B. Poddar, sir, for his guidance and support. I express my heartfelt thanks to all participants. Their active participation made this program interesting, interactive, and success. I express my sincere gratitude to all HODs and organizing members without whose support this would have not been possible. In spite of their health conditions in this pandemic situation, they strived a lot. Thanks a lot to everyone. Thank you very much. Over to you, Madam.
Thank you, madam. With the permission of dignitaries, I declare that the valedictory function has over.
Thank you.
The certificates of the participants will be mailed after evaluation of exams, assignments, and their attendance. Thank you, everyone. Stay safe. Stay home.
Share the link in chat, madam.
Yes, sir.
Exam link, can you share in the chat, please? Exam link, madam. Exam link.
This exam link will be shared in the WhatsApp group.
Okay, sir. Okay, madam.